Ladies and gentlemen, the Greater Metro Junior Hockey League proudly presents to you the Bradford Rattlers and the South Muskoka Shield. Second time these two teams have met here at the BWG here in Bradford. Starting lineups for the Bradford Rattlers. They are a little undermanned here tonight. They have four players not in the lineup tonight. Lucas Sturm, Julian McCarthy, Hunter Godmer, and Zane Clausen are not in tonight. Starting for the Bradford Rattlers, however, number 19, Alfred Malm, Christoph Kirkmeyer, Amir Mulligailov, Abraham Palma, and Pavel Rotskov are the defenders on here for Coach David Mooney's Bradford Rattlers, and the puck has dropped, and we are underway. The starting goaltenders for tonight's contest for the Bradford Rattlers, making his home Rattler debut and making his first ever Junior Hockey League start, is number 35, Alexis Poulin, native of Harvey, Saint-Pierre, Quebec, as he almost got tested there, as Alfred Malm could clean up the danger there. And for the South Muskoka Shield, it's number one, John Delaney, who gets the start and the tap to good in the goal here tonight. Puck gets fired in for Abraham Palma. Palma, the Barcelona, Spain native, make a pass to Jacob Roding. Roding had that puck stripped away from him and getting the crease is Fedor Stuka. Trying to get a chance in here is number 22, Van Doughty, trying to stuff that puck and he just couldn't quite do so. And that forces the netminder Poulin to make a good early test save there. Head coach David Mooney will change up the defense pairing. Braden Yalexi and Daniel Suda are out there for the Bradford Rattlers. Faceoff is won there by the Rattlers. That was Jesper Eriksson pulling it on back to the corner. It gets ringed along to Jacob Roding's side. Roding's side is harassed by Josh Colavito. Roding in the corner. That pass was taken off by Fedor Stuka, but it comes to the blue line. Alexi can get it across to Suda. His shot went up high and just glanced over top of the net. It's Burns back on it. You'll get it to Eriksson at the near side. His shot was blocked in front and an injured player for South Muskoka heading off to the bench. That was Van Doughty taking that puck in an awkward area of his body. Stuka can play it on the backhand. Around it comes for Brandon Mitchell. Check that. That was Isaac Locker who can make an outlet pass now to Ty Salone. Shot on goal. Poulin flexes it to the corner. Brandon Yalexi after his man back down low. Vladislav Kakarin, the defenseman for the Shield, was playing forward there. He peels on back for a change. Rattlers with possession of the puck. It's Steven Levitsky. Levitsky ran into a checking by Ty Salone and then couldn't get by Comrie. That allows Witkowski to just leave it for Yalexi, and he can play it on back to Daniel Suda. Suda and Yalexi playing catch with it. Witkowski just couldn't quite reach that pass from Yalexi from the wrong side of center. Therefore, icing is called on the Bradford Rattlers, not allowing the Rattlers to make a change in the GMHL and in the NHL if you ice the puck. The team that iced the puck is unable to make a line change, but the other team is able to. Josh Colavito, number 13 for the, or pardon me, that was number 19, Jacob Bundy there, who laid a physical check into the corner, and down goes Alexi, and he seems to be favoring his left arm. Witkowski trying to make a nice move around Bundy, and he goes into the corner now. Levitsky after it with Witkowski. Now Levitsky can toss it back to the slot. There is St. John got a shot away, and Delaney makes the save. St. John a sharp angle bid, and Delaney had the angle covered perfect, and he can make that save on the short blocker side. About 3 minutes have elapsed here in this first period of play between the Shield and the Rattlers. No score to show for, but the Rattlers have had some decent amount of shots on John Delaney, the netminder for South Muskoka here tonight. South Muskoka has kind of struggled this year. They had a pretty decent start, and then it kind of fell off from there. Shield only have 3 wins to their name right now. Rattlers currently sit at 7-1-1. Very good start, and general manager Sean Worth has to be pleased with the way his team has started this season. Outlet pass by Kirk Meyer. Couldn't find Alvred Mom. Lucas Waugh. We will be seeing more of him. Lucas Waugh, number 55 in white, due to some of the injuries and personnel that are not available here tonight for the Bradford Rattlers. Puckett flipped over for Andres Bonzimius. Couldn't clear the zone. St. John goes around. Forehand will stop up. To the blue line, it's Rotskov. Looking for Erickson. Couldn't quite get him. Burns tried to knock that down, but he has to come out of the zone and tag back onside. Rotskov can take it. Dish it to St. John. He will look up. St. John aerial dish. Blockered away by Brandon Mitchell. He was one of the players to watch out in the last outing between these two teams. Brandon Mitchell having himself quite the night, as look out, a South Muskoka Shield player running right into the cage, and that is the captain of the Shield. Captain of the Shield is number 77, Arkanshaw Pashensev. Jesper Eriksson will take the faceoff for the Rattlers against Van Doughty for the Shield. Burns right across looking for Rodin, just couldn't quite stash in. That pack will come to Abraham Palma. Nice snap pass, looking to find Burns, couldn't quite find it. Icing will be waved off. Stuka laid around, nice blocker there by Eriksson. Rodin, he'll get a shot away, got nullified and just screamed on wide. Pashensev having a word with Rodin back behind the play as he heads off. Back comes South Muskoka, it's Van Doughty, couldn't get a shot away, and now Stuka can lay it on back to the play of Tristan Sorensen, who can get it on goal to Alexis Poulin, who will be forced to hold and cover with a defensive zone faceoff coming into the Bradford Rattlers end. 15:55 time remaining in this first period. We remain a scoreless tie at 0 here from the BWG. We are glad everyone is tuning in to tonight's contest for the Sunday night on ice, and of course I gotta get that out at least once a game. Nice set play off the faceoff by Steven Levitsky. Oh, look at that. Nice juggling, dribbling effort almost with that puck. Sven Musi lost it to Vladislav Kakarin, and so Sorensen can ring it back the opposite wing. Alexi, his arm seems to be all right as he is back down on the ice, paired up with defense with Daniel Suda. Brandon Alexi doing a tremendous job just keeping that puck in, and so he'll pinch it and go into the corner. Brandon Alexi will peel it for Witkowski back down low. Looking to find Sven Musi, but he just rolled over top of his stick. And that allows South Muskoka to regain that puck. It's Ty Sloan trying to get it on deep, and racing after it is Sloan again. Sloan is bent into the corner by Witkowski. Alexi, nice stretch pass, and he will find Adam Witkowski now. He'll get it by the defender now. He'll go back down low into the corner now and looks over his options. Witkowski springs it to the blue line at St. John. He'll get a shot through, and it's gloved out of the air by John Delaney. With 14:59 to go exactly in this first period, again, a scoreless tie at 0. Bradford Rattlers are known for the quick starts, especially here at the Bradford West Gwillimbury Arena, the Leisure Center, some people call it here in town. That puck can be run back around. St. John has to come out of the zone, and a chance here on the breakaway. It's Toms Breaks, and he scores! Thomas Breaks opens the scoring for the South Muskoka Shield. They are off and running. As we mentioned about the Bradford Rattlers having good starts normally here at home, South Muskoka Shield saying, nope, none of that. We're going to switch the cards here a little bit. We're going to play a little reverse on you. And so it's the Shield who strike first, but Erickson try to get it on back. That's a nice block there by Pashensev, the captain of these South Muskoka Shield, who have a one-goal lead here tonight. Tom Spreek's latest goal scorer got into the corner after some nice, terrific soft-hand moves that he displayed there. Abraham Palma can curl and settle. Outlet pass. We're looking at William Daniel Burns, number 22 in white. Try to find Rodine, but the puck was nullified off his skate, and that allows South Muskoka to regain possession of that puck. It's Josh Colavito with 14 minutes to go in the period. His pass to the slide area was broken up by the Rattlers. Long flip pass looking for Burns. Can't do so, but he will draw a penalty on the play. Or pardon me, it's the... See, the Rattlers had the puck there. Referee didn't blow the whistle. The Shield had the puck there, and they didn't blow the whistle either for a quick second. So I was a little confused on who this penalty was going to get called against, and it looks like we're looking at him now. It's William Daniel Burns who will be going off to the penalty box for 2 minutes. High sticking will be the call. So South Muskoka, who possess a 1-0 lead over the Rattlers here with 13:51 to go in the first, will test out the game's first power play, and a good job by Steven Levitsky to send that puck down the length of the ice. And what Joe Todd would say, Nick, that's how you kill penalties. Tristan Sorensen, you see him, number 28 in black. He'll gain center, dump it in. Steven Levitsky, the forward, first after it to the corner. Can't clear the zone, but a chance here, shorthanded. It's Finn Musi. All alone, one-on-one against Delaney. Backhander, he scores! He got one last game. Tim Musi, who has back-to-back shorthanded goals. He got one last night against the West Nipissing Lynx, and he gets one here against the South Muskoka Shield. Sven Musi, shorthanded, and the Bradford Rattlers have tied it up at one. Ryan St. John's just trying to get that puck out of the zone, and that's exactly what he will do. South Muskoka Shield still up a man with another minute to go on their power play. Tom Spreeks, he has the Shield goal here tonight. We'll make an outlet pass. Nice dish and getting the zone to shake up Bundy. Stretch pass will get to the bay of Van Doughty. Doughty couldn't get a outlet pass back down into the corner, and that allows the Bradford Rattlers to get that puck out of the zone. That was a nice play by Christoph Kirkmeyer. Tom Spreeks will settle it from behind. John Delaney, the netminder for South Muskoka, and they will start on their breakout. Racing after that puck is Van Doughty. He'll get met into the corner by Daniel Suda. He and Doughty still battle away, and Doughty still gains possession of that puck. Doughty just had his pocket picked by Jesper Eriksson, allowing Braden Yalexi to send that puck down the length of the ice. John Delaney out of its cage to play it. Brings it around for Breeks. He's harassed by Jesper Eriksson shorthanded. As William Daniel Burns is set to come out of the penalty box now, the Rattlers are 1-for-1 on the PK. And a shorthanded goal by Sven Musi. Not a bad PK, not too bad. The rookie Alexis Poulin, the netminder for the Bradford Rattlers, can leave it for Braden Yalexi. Yalexi can pirouette and make a backhand pass to Rodzkov. Rodzkov's. He'll get over to Yalexi, but the puck hopped over a stick, and then he'll meet into the corner where he can flip it off the glass, but out of play. ...11:30 to go in this first period. It is a tie game at one. The Shield scoring first, and the Bradford Rattlers answering shorthanded. Sven Musi picking up his second shorthanded goal in as many nights. Steven Levitsky touched that puck from the wrong side of the blue line, thus resulting in an offside. And that one will be coming to the Rattlers' side of the neutral zone as the referees thinks it may have been intentional. Alvin Malm, number 19, will line up for the faceoff for the Bradford Rattlers. Brandon Mitchell will meet him for the shield. Malm's able to win that faceoff. Lucas Waugh took a hit from Pshensev, and the puck gets fired back in. Alvin Malm, after it, tried to center it to the front of the cage. Lucas Waugh got a shot away, but it just missed the cage. Rotzkoff chipped in back down, but a chance for Toms Briggs looking for his second of the night, and his shot was blocked down by Alexis Poulin. Mitchell, good job by him to keep the zone alive. Mitchell trying to get that puck right back, but now Doughty. Number two in black, you see him harassed there by Lucas Waugh. Stretch pass, a nice pirouette move by Tristan Sorensen, and he'll start out. He'll get over Toms Briggs. He had Abraham Palma closing in on him. And that's just a nice move by Abraham Palma, and that's what we call skating the gap. You skate as hard as you can and as fast as you can to quickly close the gap to you and the puck carrier. Daniel Burns got a shot away, kicked out by Delaney. It gets over to Rodin. Between his legs, still has possession of that puck. He'll just backhand it down low, looking for Burns, who picks his pocket from Sorensen. Burns has Eriksson to the cage, tried to find him here, but it just rolled over his stick. Eriksson the backhand. It's Rodin. His shot was swallowed into the breadbasket of John Delaney, and he will cover for an offensive faceoff coming for the Bradford Rattlers. Head coach David Mooney will get five new players onto the ice. He'll throw out the Steven Levitsky line. Ryan St. John and Henrik Wicklund, the native of Stockholm, Sweden, are paired out on defense. This is the first look we are seeing of Wicklund here tonight. Levitsky, nice job to dodge that check coming from Pshensev. Ryan St. John can dump that puck into the corner. Delaney can't reach it in time. Levitsky, he's met into the corner boards by Jacob Bunny. Levitsky turning away from his man, Vladislav Kakarin. Levitsky trying to find Witkowski. Chipping in back down low is Wicklund. The puck comes up in the air. Handled back down by Pshensev, and he can start over, but it's intercepted again. And right back to Pshensev, who can get it over to his man, Vladislav Kakarin. Witkowski did a nice job separating his man from the puck. That allows Steven Levitsky to start out. He'll chip it to himself, but a nice defensive play by Kakarin to meet him there. Adam Witkowski going into the corner. He took a hit to make a play, but he can get it to the blue line to Daniel Suda. Got a shot deflected by Malm. Big rebound. It's in the slot. Malm will pirouette, turn, and fire it. And so will Witkowski, but a nice strong save covering the low part of the net by John Delaney. Daniel Suda chipped it on goal. Witkowski tipped it, but it flutters on into the corner. Jacob Bunny's all over him. South Muskoka regains possession, and they will get it out of the zone just as far as center as Kirk Meyer. Gained that puck in, and he'll just flutter it wide of the cage. Alvin Malm first after it for the Bradford Rattlers, but the Shield quickly steal it away, and out comes Ty Sloan, number 12, for the Shield. Lucas Waugh picked his man's pocket, but it gets to the play of the South Muskoka Shield's defenseman, and they can lay it over ahead to Toms Briggs, number 21, who's the lone Shield into the zone. He looks over, trying to find his man Mitchell. It gets to Sorensen, who just shot it wide. Maybe Poulin got a piece of it with the glove. Nice keeping alive by Grimaldi. His shot tipped by Mitchell, and it goes up and out of play. I'd like to quickly say right now, on the GMHL website for the South Muskoka Shield, they have a few player numbers wrong that we have on our sheet right here in front of us for the broadcast here tonight. So if I say a wrong player's name or wrong number, or if it's just the wrong name and number completely, I do apologize. I'm just going off the information that is on GMHL.com. Don't shoot the commentator. Shoot the guy that's doing the website. Nah, I'm just kidding. That puck is then handled by the Shield netminder, number one, John Delaney, with 7 minutes and 50 seconds to go in this first period. We are tied up at one apiece. Toms Briggs getting the opening goal for the Shield, and Sven Muser answering shorthanded for the Bradford Rattlers. That puck can skip away from Pavel Rotzkoff, and so Abraham Palmas after it, the Barcelona, Spain native. A nice chip pass from Rotzkoff to Rodin, and now Eriksson. Eriksson gains his own. Nice pass to Rodin. His shot snatched out of the air by John Delaney. Sven Musi, the only Rattler, with a goal here tonight. He's able to win that faceoff, but the Shield are right there in the right place at the right time. I think let's get that puck down as far as center and peeling on back into his own zone is the Alexi, who can make an outlet dish to Witkowski. Clean entry by the Rattlers. Alexi scores! And Yuxley says, I'll do it myself. He takes it from the neutral zone, and that's what the Rattlers were missing. They were missing that clean break-in to the Shield zone. That's exactly what they just did there. And as soon as Brandon Alexi just got it past the blue line, he just whips it low blocker on John Delaney. And if you're John Delaney and you're the Shield, you got to think, you got to try to have that one. If you're John Delaney, you're sure he's going to want that shot back. The Bradford Rattlers are back into the zone. It's Amir Malagaila looking for Lucas Waugh in the slot area. Couldn't quite connect on him. And so Ty Salone can make an outlet pass intercepted by St. John. And so two 19s on both teams collide in front of the timekeeper's area. Lucas Waugh, a nice interception off Vladislav Kukarin, and he'll dump it into the corner. Oliver Malm offering some re-support. A backhand effort. Trying to get out of the zone to Jacob Bundy. Couldn't quite do so. Alfred Malm is pinned up into the corner, though. He gets knocked down, but he pops back up. Nice keep in by Lucas Waugh. He has a chance here to skate in, and he just shot it wide. May have had a stick checked on the play. Jacob Bundy from his own zone. For South Muskoka with 6:20 to go in this first period. Jesper Eriksson can play to St. John, who can get it over for Rohde. Rodin stretch pass, he'll get to Roskov, who just got onto the ice surface, who'll just dump it into the corner, then handled off by John Delaney, the netminder for the Shield, who'll ring it over for Sorensen's way, but it's intercepted by Musi, who can play it over for Eriksson, who couldn't get a shot away. Coming in is Burns to offer some support, and that shot was redirected into the corner where Burns is there first. Nice hard pass for Rodin's way. He'll make a head fake, dip his shoulder, put it right towards the crease area, and then that puck is then swallowed up by John Delaney, the netminder for South Muskoka, and he will hold with 5:45 to go in this first period. 2-1 for the Bradford Rattlers here tonight after South Muskoka scored first. Jesper Eriksson on the faceoff. He won it. Burns gains right into the backhand. He got hooked on the way, and the Bradford Rattlers will get a chance to test out their first power play of the contest here tonight. That's not just a nice job by William Daniel Burns. That's exactly what you want to see from your forwards off the faceoff. You just want to take everything you can, drive yourself and the puck to the cage, try to create some havoc. And that's just playing hard. William Daniel Burns was just playing hard right there, and good thing, because he drew a penalty. And now it's a beautiful opportunity with 5:38 to go in the first period for the Bradford Rattlers to get a power play goal and go up by two. Sven Musi, Pavel Rodskov, Jacob Rodin, Jesper Eriksson, and Steven Levitsky. David Mooney has thrown those five players out here for the Rattlers here in white tonight. Steven Levitsky off the faceoff to Eriksson. He'll just get a shot away, maybe looking for a redirection. Couldn't quite get it there. Nice job by Pesentsev. He just clears that puck out of the zone, handled by Eriksson. And now you're looking at number 14, Steven Levitsky. Very skilled winger the Bradford Rattlers have here in number 14. A shot redirected by Levitsky, and it winds up in. Canada, Ontario's William Daniel Burns gets it on the power play, and sometimes got to be good to get lucky, and good thing William Daniel Burns is a very good player. Got a little lucky there off that redirection off a South Muskoka defender's skate, and then it goes between the wickets of the netminder John Delaney. That's just a tough one for South Muskoka. Can't really put the blame on anyone there. That's just a hockey play. Brandon Alexi will leave it for Daniel Suda. Suda looking for Kristaps Kirkmeier. He found him. tried to get out of the zone, but he couldn't quite get it as far as center, as Mulligailov is there to offer some support. But that allows Tristan Sorensen to make a drop pass to Salone. Mitchell back across for Sorensen, just couldn't quite get a trigger pull in time, as Daniel Suda is met with a check behind the goal by Salone, allowing the Rattlers to break out. It's Levinsky. Oh, he put everything he had on that shot of going down. McKay, he got a shot away and he scores. McKay, number 21, or pardon me, 12. It's for South Muskoka. Makes it 3-2. The netminder for the Shield, John Delaney, has a goal he would probably want back. And if you're the Rattlers netminder, Alexis Poulin, you're going to probably want that one back as well. So you give what you get. Both sides have allowed in kind of a shaky goal, if you will. Shield have cut that deficit from 2-1. That's exactly what you want if you're in South Muskoka's shoes right now. Daniel Burns trying to get by Pashentsev, couldn't do so. Bunzinius will get it across, looking for his man in front. Was Van Doughty. Collision in front. Pashentsev pops back up. Rattlers touch that puck, but they are offside. 3 minutes and 32 seconds remain in this first period. Rattlers do lead by a goal, but it's the Shield who have cashed in most recently. Breeks and McKay, the goal scorers for South Muskoka. Nice play by Lucas Waugh off the faceoff. Braden Yalexi will punch it over his way. Nice keep in by Tristan Sorensen. Yalexi will just scream that puck down the length of the ice for an icing call on the Rattlers, and they might deserve that one. A little sloppy off that faceoff for the Bradford Rattlers, resulting in an icing call. Reading Brandon Yalexi's face there, I think he believed they were still on the penalty kill. He looked up at the big scoreboard above the Rattlers netminder right now, and he kind of got a good chuckle with his teammates there. I mean, it happens. I know I've done that before. Alexis Poulin can play it, and he will. Does it for Brandon Yalexi. Got it to the corner. Kirk Meyer can get it over to Lucas Waugh. Lucas Waugh met by a stick check by Sorensen. Over in Mom looking for a stick check there, so was Kirk Meyer. Shield get that puck into the zone. The shot went wide from Sorensen. Vladislav Kukarin, nice keep in by him, but the Rattlers finally get that puck out of the zone. Ice seems to be a little tilted in favor for South Muskoka. They seem to be having all the momentum right now, as St. John can be the first Rattler player after that puck into the corner. He'll just skate it out of his zone, looking for Levinsky, who touches it. Puck got sent back down, and so Reeves takes it for the Shield. Van Doughty, number two, for the Shield, will just leave it over for Toms Breeks. McKay, he'll gain the zone. A curl and drag move. Poulin just steers it aside to the corner with 2:05 to go in the first period. Sharp angle bid by Doughty, just flipped on wide. Pashentsev from the blue line. He'll stutter and just get it back down onto the corner. McKay after it now, under 2 minutes to go. He'll side it across, broken up by Ryan St. John, and he'll play it from the backhand out of play. 2 minutes and 2 minutes. That was the NHL. That would be a delay of game penalty. But in the GMHL, just results in a defensive zone faceoff for the team that sent that puck out of play from their own end. Jacob Bundy from the faceoff. McKay coming in to help win it. Flipped it across for Toms Breeks' way. Steven Levitsky to Sven Musi. Sven Musi, he puts on the wheels now. He tries to go to the backhand to the forehand, put it right to the slot area. Couldn't quite connect with Steven Levitsky. A turnaround pass went right to the stick of Sven Musi, who can make a backhand saucer dish as he's getting off for a change. And Yalexi can play it over for Daniel Suda, number 24, in white for the Rattlers. It's Jacob Rodin Trying to get by the checking play of Jacob Bundy, and he still has it. Rodine does. Try to find Burns, who whacked at it, but it gets cleaned up in the slot area, but Rodine is still after it. Rodine goes back down low, try to put it to the forehand, couldn't do so. Gets to the corner where Suda can keep the zone alive. He'll flutter it into the glove of Delaney, but it comes out. Rodine met by check a play of Sorensen. Pashensev can rink it wide for McKay's way. McKay met by Suda. Burns coming in to help him there. Suda battling away. William Daniel Burns looking for the slot for Rodine was intercepted by Sorensen. Braden Yalexi, good job on the backhand to pinch in to keep the puck alive. Jesper Eriksson, number 8 in white. He'll let a shot go, and it just screamed on wide. Pavel Rodzkov out on defense for the Rattlers, but that pass by Burns is intercepted. Aerial lift to center. Nice play by Rodzkov to lead that play to know exactly where that puck was going to drop. Bezhentsev from his own end was broken up. Not out of the zone just yet. Burns got it into the corner where Levitsky can give chase over Klo. Rodzkov picks up that puck. He tries to play it over to Levitsky's way. Couldn't do so, but Levitsky will be the first after it against Vladislav Kakarin. He tried to find his man Witkowski, but that puck coming out of the zone for Abraham Palma, and that will conclude the first period of play, pardon me. You see on the big scoreboard, after 20 minutes, Rattlers 3, the Shield 2. We'll be back for the second period of play after this intermission. Second period set to get underway from the BWG here in Bradford. PA announcer here in Bradford, Travis Defoe, getting everybody on their feet and making noise here to start this second period. And the puck is dropped and we are underway for the second frame of regulation time. It's Jacob Rodin, who is met by a check there by Deschanette. Kakarin can play it to the opposite corner, flexed away by Sorensen. Sorensen stretch pass looking for Yaleksi was there to intercept, so Daniel Suda, the defenseman, joining in. He'll pass it over for Jesper Eriksson. Eriksson looking over, he's pressured off by Kakarin. Coming in to help is Sorensen, but Witkowski with a good steal. Witkowski left it over for Eriksson. Eriksson, a backhand dish to Braden Yaleksi. From the half boards, looks over, tries to get it right to the front of the net. Delaney may have got a piece of that one, sweeping it to the corner. Adam Witkowski racing after it. Plays it to Yaleksi, a backhand dish to Levitsky. He leaves it over for Jesper Eriksson. Drops it, Steven Levitsky. Stopped on a dime, Abraham Palma joining the zone. He'll get it here. Palma, his shot blocker down by Delaney. It comes up in the air and drops into the half boards near the corner where the Shield can regain possession. It's Mitchell making a stretch pass to his man, Toms Breeks, who has the goal here tonight. He will head off on a change, and so Pavel Rodskov takes it for the Bradford Rattlers. William Daniel Burns, 22, and White, trying to get by Pashensev, and then once more trying to get by Van Dowdy. Burns strips the puck. Levitsky scores! Steven Levitsky was set up perfectly by William Daniel Burns right in Levitsky's wheelhouse, and he makes no mistake slapping it on the one-timer over the glove of John Delaney, and the Bradford Rattlers have reopened their two-goal lead. Crow unable to win the face-off for the Shield. That allows Kirkmeyer to make a stretch pass to Abraham Palma, who has Mulligailov with him. Palma, that was a blistering shot that just missed on the glove side. Shield to possession, it's Bozek. Lost it to Kirkmeyer. Met by a check there by Crow. Abraham Palma, he takes that puck into his corner. Brings it around to Pavel Rodskov. South Muskoka has really come out in the second period, hitting anything that moves in a white uniform here. Bradford Rattlers have to notice that and adapt quickly. As the more you play against an aggressive forechecking and backchecking team, the more prone you are to make mistakes and take a penalty or let in a goal. So if you're the Bradford Rattlers, maybe try using your speed to your advantage here. Get those plays off where you chip the puck off the boards and then skate around your defender and race for that puck. Plays like that, just try to avoid any contact here tonight. Witkowski is going to use his speed here, looking for a fifth spot, gets hooked on the way, and he will draw a penalty. Adam Witkowski left it for Rodin. Across, he takes it. Rodin, a shot, he scores! Bradford Rattlers lead by 3 here in the early going to the second period. It's 5-2 for the Bradford Rattlers. Jacob Rodin going in between the legs of John Delaney. And Rodin picks up his first goal of tonight's contest. Van Dowdy played it along. A backhand dish effort was made by Toms Breeks. The puck goes into the corner. Wicklund played it on across. That shot whipped on wide. Poulin never saw it on the way. Burns from center looking for Musi. He puts Pashensev on the ground. And it looks like Musi will be called for interference. And this is a great opportunity for the Shield to get back within two goals. This is the biggest lead of tonight's contest, 3 goals. Sven Musi, who got a shorthanded goal here tonight. He's one more Rattler. He's the Rattlers, I'd argue, most important penalty-killing player for head coach David Mooney, and unfortunately, they will be without Sven Musi for 2 minutes. Again, he got that shorthanded goal, the first Rattler goal here tonight, to tie the game up at one, as you see Alexis Poulin make a glove save coming off the stick of Mitchell. Brayden Mitchell, he has the right mindset right there. You're down by 3 on the power play early in the second period. Just start firing whatever you can on this rookie netminder for the Bradford Rattlers. And again, Alexis Poulin, number 35, the goaltender for Bradford, making his first ever junior hockey start here tonight, as he's got to watch out for Ty Salone tying his man up in front of the net with Daniel Suda. They are in quite the battle in front of the eyes of Poulin. Shield with possession, however. It's Sorensen leaving across. One-timer by Mitchell. Glove down and covered by Alexis Poulin. The goals in this first period for the Bradford Rattlers coming a minute apart. Levitsky and Roding. Of course, Sven Musi in the penalty box right now for interference. Shield still remain on the power play. They are down by 3 here as we stand, as McKay can pirouette and get a shot away, but it just goes wide into the corner where Doughty can play it away. Rodine had his pocket picked, but Pavel Rozkov's in the right place at the right time to lift it over for Erickson, who stops into his own zone again and just gets it across to Ryan St. John, who flutter it but kind of fanned on that clearing attempt. Pavel Rozkov from center trying to chip it for Levitsky, and then he will then skate after it against Brayden Mitchell. 55 seconds to go on the power play for South Muskoka. They regain possession. It's Tom Breeks, number 21 in black, gaining the zone. Looks to drop it, but he'll just stop on a dime and play it for Brayden Mitchell. He'll walk in, get a shot, stopped by Poulin. The puck was loose, but the referee lost signal of it. That's him blowing his whistle to a halt and stop play for a defensive zone faceoff coming up for the Bradford Rattlers. 41 seconds to go until the Rattlers are back to 5-on-5. 15:20 to go in the second period. Rattlers lead by 5-3. This is the biggest lead of tonight's contest. Shorthanded opportunity for Steven Levitsky. He has Adam Witkowski, a 2-on-1. Witkowski shoots, glove stopped by Delaney. Not sure I quite heard a whistle, but looks like one was sounded. If you're just tuning in tonight, Rattlers are a little short-staffed here tonight, as you see Witkowski get a shot right off the faceoff, and Delaney had to be alert to make that save. That's just good positioning by the South Muskoka netminder. I played ball hockey goalie once, and I had this guy who used to be an ice hockey goalie. He always told me, Nick, what you want to do with the blade of your goaltender's stick. The blade of it has to follow the puck everywhere it goes, or in this case, it was a ball. Everywhere the ball goes, your blade of your goaltender stick has to be matched up exactly into the center of the puck or the ball to make sure you're in perfect position at all time. Little goaltending fact I'll throw out here for you guys that I learned in my days of playing hockey, though it wasn't rep or anything, you know, come on, I'm not that good. Just a little things you learn on the way, I just thought maybe I could share a little bit of my wisdom, which it isn't a lot, but I like to think I can at least do provide a little knowledge. Just a little bit. Enough about me. Back to the action here. Come on. We are back to 5-on-5. Sven Musi is out of the penalty box, and the puck comes right to him. Off the stick of Van Doughty. Musi got a shot away, and a windmill glove grab made by John Delaney, who makes it look very, very routine for him. And that's a characteristic I'm noticing here tonight about John Delaney, the netminder for the Shield. He is very quick and very good on the glove side. And I think most of the goals here tonight have been low blocker and five falls. You see John Delaney do a great job covering the low part of the cage to deny St. John off that shot. But if you're John Delaney, you're playing very good here tonight, especially with your glove hand. If you're the Bradford Rattlers, if you want to get more goals past John Delaney, you got to start looking over to the blocker side and maybe trying to go five hole again. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. If I were head coach David Mooney, I'm telling the boys right now, do not shoot for the glove. Do not shoot that side because Delaney is too good with his glove. Amir Malagailov, number 28 in white, you see him now. Played across, Lucas Waugh looked to be interfered with. Rattlers looking for a penalty, they will not get it. Malagailov did a nice job, come back. It's Wicklund playing it on back, intercepted there by Sorensen. He'll play it up the gut to Salone. Met by a check there by Waugh. It's Rodine, who has a goal here tonight, number 91. For the Bradford Rattlers, Malagailov took that puck away, couldn't find Oliver Malm, and so he'll just head off for a line change. Erickson and Witkowski come back on for David Mooney's Rattlers. Alexis Poulin made that save, and he redirected it into the corner. Bozek in on after it. He'll leave it over for McKay. McKay looking to try to get over for Crow at the blue line, but McKay is back down low, number 12, for the Shield. McKay surveys the scene. He lost it from Rodine, but picks it on back. McKay lost it to Witkowski. Witkowski stopped on a dime to get away from McKay, but he's all over him, and he takes Witkowski down. Trying to find that puck is McKay, and he finally picks it up. Plays it off the half boards. The shot from the blue line rang off the pipe in front. That shot came off from Tristan Sorensen's stick as another one came from him, and it just deflected and fluttered up and into protective mesh out of play. Referee will get a new puck from PA announcer Travis Defoe in the timekeeper's area. And we got an offensive faceoff for the Shield. Okay. William Daniel Burns, you're looking at him now. He can get by Doughty. Burns, a diving effort made by Pashentsev, couldn't get it by, and so it gets pinned up into the corner. We're firing that puck down the length of the ice is Tristan Sorensen, so getting it first is Roscoff, the former Bancroft Rockhound and Bradford Rattler. This is his second stint with the Bradford Rattlers. Roscoff's been in this organization for, I would say, I think this is his fourth year affiliated with the Rattlers, if you will. That one got sent from the wrong side of center by the Bradford Rattlers, resulting in an icing call. One thing I've noticed about South Muskoka as well, they don't ice the puck. They don't really force plays that aren't there. They like to make a clean breakout and like to skate in with numbers and lots of support breaking into the Rattlers' zone. The Bradford Rattlers, however, there's been a few times where they have iced the puck, and this might be another instance, unless Daniel Burns can beat up the icing, and it looks like he cannot. The Bradford Rattlers, they got to be a little more cleaner, just getting that puck out of their zone. Maybe try to take that puck in more deep behind your cage and try to start a breakout there. If they can win the faceoff here, which will be a key one here, and if you win the faceoff for the Rattlers, you just don't want to fire it off the glass and out. Try to settle it down and see what you can get starting out on a breakout. And it looks like the Rattlers will do so here. They got a 2-on-1 if they hurry. Levitsky with Burns. Burns, backhander in front, looking for Levitsky. It gets right back into the net mouth. And John Delaney comes up strong on that chance for the Bradford Rattlers. McKay, can he get back in deep? We're under 11 minutes to go here in this second period. McKay racing after his man. Abraham Palma takes it for the Rattlers. He'll play it for Kirk Meyer. Not out of the zone. Good keep in by Sorensen. Galexi calmly plays it from the backhand to Lucas Waugh. Waugh can get that puck up and out of the zone and drops right to Alvin Malm. Malm turns away looking for Kirk Meyer. Couldn't slash him there. Puck comes right in front. Loose for a rebound by Lucas Waugh. Just couldn't quite stash it past Delaney. It goes into the corner where Christoph Kirk Meyer's after it. He'll get it to Lucas Waugh. He'll get a shot away. Stopped by Delaney. It's loose. And then John Delaney finally pounces over that rebound. But Lucas Waugh, great opportunity for him to get on the score sheet here tonight. David Mooney seems to trust that lineup right now with him, Kirk Meyer, and Alvin Malm. That third line getting a little more action, especially here tonight due to the key injuries that the Bradford Rattlers have here tonight. Again, no Lucas Sturm, Julian McCarthy, Hunter Godmer, and Zane Clausen. Those four are not available to play for the Bradford Rattlers here tonight. Rodine, try to get that puck to Daniel Suda off the stick of Brandon Mitchell. Brandon Yalexi out in Witkowski. Roding drops it for Erickson, but the Rattlers were offside. Bradford Rattlers' next home game will be on November 13th against, guess who? This exact same team, the South Muskoka Shield, will be back here next Sunday to take on the Bradford Rattlers. Wickland meets his man into the corner for the Rattlers. He didn't get that puck out of the zone. Icing will be waved off as Levitsky gets to it first. Levitsky backhander, he scores! Steven Levitsky uses his speed to his advantage, beats every player in a black uniform on the ice, and he stashes it on the backhand against John Delaney, and the Bradford Rattlers have opened up a 6-2 lead with 10:22 to go in the second period. And it's all looking good right now for the boys in white right now. Van Dowdy from center, Pashensev just dumps it in. Poulin can play with his goal stick behind for Rodzkov. The puck laid on the side of the net. Rodzkov gives the net a nice slash to pop that puck back onto the ice surface. Crow just gets that puck in deep. Dirk Meyer plays it down low. Travis Defoe announcing the hat trick goal for Steven Levitsky. That gets a nice little pop of excitement for the Bradford Rattler bench just for a quick second. Quickly died down. As the Bradford Rattlers, the job is nowhere near complete. They still got 10 minutes to go in the second period and then a full 20-minute period. Shield are back in. It's Crow. Had his pocket picked by Roding. Witkowski's trailing on the far side. Erickson will join the rush as well. Roding leaves it for Erickson. Nice play. Erickson trying to get it right back to Roding. He does so here. Stash it across. Witkowski rang it off the pipe. Or maybe Delaney got a piece of it. Witkowski tied up in the half corner. It plays over for Erickson. Erickson looks over on the wraparound attempt there. Delaney read it and came across strong to deny Jesper Erickson, who has it again. Erickson sauces it. Yalexi in front there. Witkowski tried to get it in front. But South Muskoka still dodging a bunch of bullets right now as Delaney can finally pounce on that puck and halt play for his team, who had a clinic kind of ran on him right there. Bradford Rattler is moving the puck with some sort of pace and skill. South Muskoka were just too tired with the bodies they had out there. They just couldn't do anything to match it. If you're head coach David Mooney for the Rattlers, this is exactly what you want to see. You don't want to see this, however. It's McKay with a chance here on goal, and he just whipped it wide. Kakarin lost it from Musi. Puck was bobbling over him, and so McKay can play it around. Intercepted by Burns. Back to Yalexi to center. It's Levitsky. The man with the hat trick. He got flattened there by Tom's Breeks. Burns to the center. Cuts across. Shot deflected. Up and out of play. That got the South Muskoka bench kind of live, laying on their feet. Seeing the man with the hat trick who's been doing all sorts of damage to the Shield here tonight, Steven Levitsky, getting sent to the ground. And if you're the Shield, that's what you want. You want to see hits like that. You just want to keep the positive plays going. Get more shots, get more hits, start building some momentum with 8 minutes to go in the second period and see what you can do heading into the third period of play. Still a lot of time left in the second period, however. Wickland try to pinch in to keep the zone alive. He'll do so there. Mitchell intercept, but it gets right back to Roding. Alfred Malm takes it from the slot. His shot missed wide on the glove side. Lucas wobbles right there. Puck bobbled away, and it jumped up in the air and then settled into the corner and then sent back down the length of the ice, where icing can be waved off by the back official. Hendrik Wickland met with a check there, but he can outlet a pass to Waugh, and now Alfred Malm. Malm a backhand dish across. It's Gripnik, a shot just went wide of the stick. Or pardon me, that was Christoph Kirkmeyer. Palma intercepted by the Shield. They have numbers here. A three on one developing, but the Shield are offside. Brandon Mitchell is beside himself right now. He can't believe it. We have 7 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the second period. Rattlers have 6 goals. The Shield have 2. At number 35 for the Rattlers, their netminder, Alexis Poulin, making his first ever junior hockey start here tonight for the Rattlers, who has been very good as well. For the boys in white right now, Shield to the puck, however. It's Crow looking to get it back down low. Erickson's all over his man, picked up by Wachowski, try to get by his man, and he'll do so here. Wachowski racing after it against Sorensen. He'll just pitch it along across for Rodin's way. Rodin racing on after, played it to his man. A one-timer in front there. Went off the side of the cage, back into the corner boards. Stretch pass in. Back comes Kakarin. Had his shot blocked, but Crow picks it up with Rodzkov all over him. Centering pass nullified by Erickson. A backhand dish to center, looking for Rodin. Couldn't quite get him. Erickson off that flutter attempt by Pashensev. Takes it in. Erickson in a stick, obliterated in two. There's $400 down the drain. Steven Levitsky picks up that puck. The hat trick man can play it over for Abraham Palma. Palma, drop pass to no one there. Pavel Rodzkov will go after that rolling puck. He'll settle back down, turn around, look over the options. Steven Levitsky, nice stutter step move, and he'll break in. Levitsky, he'll go between the legs, back to the front. Musi trying to punch it away, but a nice play by Delandy to knock it away. Rodzkov, good keeping. Palma takes it from him. He'll tee one up, and he fanned on it. Went wide, but it got over to Musi, who's harassed by two players from South Muskoka. That allows Pashensev to take that puck. He was stick-checked there by Burns, and now Musi takes it. Musi looking for Burns, couldn't connect. Sauce pass, it's Levitsky on the backhand, looking across there for Burns, and he just couldn't quite stash it in. Stretch pass tipped in by Levitsky. It's loose for a brief moment, until the whistle finally sounds, as Delaney may have covered it for just a couple seconds, allowing the referee to blow the whistle. 5 minutes and 25 seconds to go exactly in the second period. Again, Bradford Rattlers have 6 goals to the South Muskoka Shields 2. We're happy that everyone is tuning in to tonight's contest from wherever you are. We do thank you for tuning in here on YouTube Live to watch this Sunday night action on ice between the Rattlers and the Shield. Lucas Wall couldn't get by Kakarin. Kakarin couldn't get the puck away out of the zone. Galexi did a good job just to knock it down with good hand-eye coordination and just shovel that puck into the zone. South Muskoka Shield will do the exact same thing, however. It's Sorensen doing it for his team, but icing is then called on their team. Good step up there by St. John, and down on the ice is Tom Breeks. He may have injured his left knee on the play, and he's hobbling onto the bench. Picked up by Ryan St. John. He's flexed off the puck by Mitchell. Brandon Mitchell back down low to get it off Lucas Wall. Couldn't do so. Wall will set up Malm. His shot gloved in front by Delaney. I'll give credit to the South Muskoka Shield. Their body language has not slacked off one bit. They are still upbeat. The boys are still standing up on the bench. No one's really hanging their heads on the bench for South Muskoka. So, for their sake, hopefully they can find some motivation in this second intermission, or maybe they can get a quick goal to close out this second period and gain momentum heading into the third. Let's see. Oh, look out. Daniel Suda with a huge hit back behind the play. That allows Rodin to gain the zone for the Rattlers. He stops on a dime and looks over the options. Try to get over for Erickson. Couldn't quite do so. Wachowski turns and fired that shot into the pads of Delaney, and he will cover with no further play with 4 minutes and 12 seconds to go in this second period. Amanda Baxter, we can't wait as well. Hopefully Tyler is doing well in his recovery, and hopefully the injury seems to be going away a little bit. We do hope to see Tyler Baxter back here in the Rattler uniform very, very soon, as he is definitely missed. Abraham Palma threatened to step up on Brandon Mitchell, forcing Mitchell just to quickly dump that puck into the zone. Burns in a battle. Palma sending his man to the ice. Musi, he laid a physical check as well. The body checking starting to pick up here late in the second period. Let's see if it continues heading into the third. Crow try to get by Levitsky. He'll do so here. Stretch pass intercepted by Rhodeskov. He'll turn it aside to Burns. Burns will use his speed. He'll stop up a little bit. Looking over the options is Burns. Burns to Palma from the blue line. He'll skate in. Got a shot away. Kicked on wide. Alexei try to keep the zone alive. He'll do so here. He took a bump for his efforts, though, but the puck still played inside the zone. Then it's coming out as Alexei needs to punch on back, but McKay was all over him to nullify that DDD pass to Palma. Palma can then make a pass for Kirk Meyer, but then intercepted and slapped back in by the Shield. Braden Alexei from his own end. Left it for Kirk Meyer. Malm will skate it in. Number 19 in white has Lucas Waugh. And Kirk Meyer with him. He dropped it to Kirk Meyer, who got a shot away. Breadbasket save made by John Delaney. Lucas Waugh was all after his defenseman there. Trying to get it by Salone. Puck comes into the corner boards and then skated back out. Nice keep in by Alexei, but the puck then finally comes out of the zone, thankfully, for South Muskoka. As far as center, Malm can chop it on back for Suda, and he will restart. Malm trying to knock it down. The pass was too far behind him. Lucas Waugh giving chase over his man. Had the privilege to interview Lucas Waugh a couple of games ago in the first intermission of one of the games. Good chat with the Quebec native. English could be a little better, but Lucas Waugh definitely making some improvements, especially to his English and to his game on the ice. I've seen major improvements early in the season from Lucas Waugh as Erickson just trying to lift it over the pad of Delaney with 2 minutes to go exactly, and he just couldn't quite stash it in, was Erickson. Delaney's done a good job here tonight, taking away the lower part of the net. He has been beaten in the five hole. One of them was a good shot by Alexei. The other one was a redirection of a turn play by Levitsky. That was the one goal early, I believe, in this period or the first period, where Levitsky got that lucky bank shot in. You gotta be good to get lucky, though, so you can't fault him. Against Steven Levitsky with a hat trick. Here tonight, we are under 2 minutes to go in this second period. 6 for the Rattlers, 2 for the Shield. Kakarin from his own end. Looking for his man McKay. Went by his stick. Played along by St. John. Back over for Jakob Rodin. Rodin, DDD to Wicklund. Wicklund stash-shaded across to St. John. Try to aerial it to Wachowski. He uses his speed. Got hooked on the way. He will draw a penalty. Centered it for Rodin. St. John will just get it towards the goal. Deflected on wide. And it will get to the play for Erickson. Punches it back down low to the play of Wachowski, then touched up by the Shield, and they will be called with the penalty. Vladislav Kakarin will be the guilty party heading off for South Muskoka. Hooking is the call, and what Joe Todd used to say to me all the time, Nick, hooking is illegal on and off the ice. Something Joe Todd would always say to me whenever there was a hooking call called. So a little shout out to Joe Dodd. Joe Dodd's taught me a lot, and if you remember us two doing the games a while back, it's crazy to think I used to be his color commentator about maybe 6 or 5 years ago. Shout out to Joe Todd if he is watching here tonight. Wachowski, that puck hit him on the way. He didn't even notice it. Pavel Rhodeskov whipped it across, intercepted by the Shield as Brandon Mitchell, with a minute to go in the second period, played it along, gloved down by Rhodeskov, and he'll start out again. Pavel Rhodeskov tried to get by his man Sorensen. He nullified that play, and so he could slap it off the glass and send that puck down the length of the ice. You're looking at Ryan St. John, number 13 in white for the Bradford Rattlers, with a minute 22 to go on the power play. He'll weave his way into the Shield zone, and he'll look over the options again. St. John to Rodskov. Pavel Rodskov will walk the line. A head fake, a shot got through, looking for a tip by Witkowski. Couldn't quite get him there. He's in a corner boards battle with Tom Breeks. Intercepted there and picked over by Eriksson. In front for Burns, and he just stashed it wide. Burns back after it, however. Plays it across to Ryan St. John. You see him there. He'll pirouette to Oliver and Malm. Now across to Rodskov. They have 10 seconds to work with in the period. They got to get a shot away, and they do so here, but a flutter's on wide as Rodskov can escape the zone with the puck. And that will conclude period number two. After 40 minutes of regulation time, the Bradford Rattlers 6, the South Muskoka Shield 2. We'll be back for the third period of play after this brief intermission. We are back for the third period of action. Again, the Bradford Rattlers are on the power play for another 20 more seconds. A little delay for that third period. Two members of the Bradford Bulls came up to chat with me once again. And it's always good to see the other teams coming to town, you know, shooting the you-know-what with them. And just good guys over there for the Bradford Bulls. And, of course, we're the Rattlers, so I ain't supposed to say that, but off the ice, they are very, very good, humble guys. And we wish, maybe a little controversial, but we do wish the Bradford Bulls a little bit of luck. We wish them a little bit of luck over here. Not a lot, not a lot. This third period is early, only 19:12 to go in it. Shot by Alexei from the line, screamed on wide. Daniel Suda after the pinch up first. Malagailov's way was intercepted, and then Sorensen takes it from his own end. Sorensen was then intercepted by Kirk Meyer. Giveaway there. Over and Malm after it. Kirk Meyer into the corner. Puck was broken up by Sorensen. He'll start back out. Stuka tried to gain the zone. Suda lost his stick on the play. Good tie up by Daniel Suda there. Puck comes to possession of Kirk Meyer. Kirk Meyer played it around, intercepted, slapped back in by the shield. And so Alexis Poulin out of his cage to leave it for his defenseman, Braden Yaleksi. Yaleksi off the boards. Lost it to Crow. McKay picks it up. Yaleksi, nice read to take that puck away. Yaleksi, stretch P to St. John. St. John up it comes to Levitsky. It gets to center where Mitchell can play it away, but Levitsky with the hat trick here tonight can take it again. Levitsky back in, has Musi on the far side. Nice move by Levitsky. A backhander juggled and then caught once more by John Delaney. Again, next Sunday, the Bradford Rattlers will be hosting these exact same South Muskoka Shield. That is a 7:30 puck drop, November 13th. November 20th, the Meaford Knights will take on the Bradford Rattlers. Then November 27th, West Nipissing will meet the Rattlers once again. As that shot coming from Musi was knocked down by Delaney. Sven Musi faked the one-timer and he scores! Sven Musi, his second goal of the contest, his first even-strength goal, makes it 7-2 for the Bradford Rattlers. I was a little confused in what Sven Musi was doing. He quickly did a pirouette, faked the slap shot, and then reloaded and took a slap shot again, and it just blistered it over the glove of John Delaney. And I was saying earlier in this contest, if you're the Bradford Rattlers, you do not want to be shooting high glove on John Delaney. But what does Sven Musi do? Beat John Delaney over the high glove, and it is a 7-2 lead for the Bradford Rattlers. Roding with the puck back for the Rattlers. Witkowski dropped it over for Erickson. A diving effort made by the netminder Delaney to cover up that puck with 17 minutes to go exactly in this last frame of regulation time play. Steven Levitsky, a hat trick. Sven Musi with two goals. Roding got himself on the goal sheet as well. William Daniel Burns as well. A lot of happy players for the Bradford Rattlers here tonight. Pavel Rodzkov, nice job to finish his check and separate his man to the puck. And that's what I talked about earlier about skating the gap. That's exactly what Rodzkov did there. He skated the gap. Erickson can pass it over to Abraham Palma. Palma will corral the puck and regroup. Pavel Rodzkov will do the exact same thing. He outlets it to Erickson and he'll gain in. Jesper Erickson from his backhand left it for Witkowski, who just screamed it wide. Fired in from center by Suda, glove down and then played by the netminder Delaney. He'll drop it for Pshensev. with Lucas Waugh all over him. He'll get it to Van Doughty. Doughty looking over for Bozek with Malagailov all over him. Slapped in by Brandon Mitchell. Alvin Malm taking it, number 19, and White can backhand it to himself off the boards. 3-on-3, even numbers back into the shield zone. It's Lucas Waugh from the high slot. His shot scores! No letting up by the Bradford Rattlers. They have just popped in an eighth spot on John Delaney, who remains in the contest here. And with 15:35 to go in the third period, the South Muskoka Shield have elected to do runtime. Shout out to Travis Defoe, PA announcer here in Bradford, making the goal scoring announcement. Lucas Waugh, number 55 for the Bradford Rattlers, was the one who scored the goal for Bradford. Good to see Lucas Waugh finally getting all that hard work paved off. We've mentioned early in this contest, Lucas Waugh has developed and progressed tremendously from the first time I saw him. And of course, I did that interview with him, I believe it was in the home opener of this season, and did a first period intermission interview with Lucas Waugh. His English could use a little bit of work, but I talked to him last Sunday again with the game here in Bradford. His English has improved a lot, and his play has improved a lot, and it's just very rewarding for him to see Lucas Waugh finally get on the board here, especially at home. Again, for all of you watching back at home, it's 8-2 for the Bradford Rattlers with 14:20 to go exactly in this third period. When the whistle sounds, the clock will not stop running down to zero. It is quite the large margin in this game tonight. So the referees and the South Muskoka Shield have elected to just run the clock even when the whistle blows. If this sounds familiar, then you would be right. This is kind of a theme sometimes for the Bradford Rattlers. They like to run up the score, if you would, resulting in runtime. Erickson on after it. Wicklin from the backhand. He tried to shovel it back down low deep. Erickson will try to do the same, but he's pinned up against the boards by Delay. Erickson still battling with it. Puck got fired up to the corner, and nice kick in at the blue line by Wicklin. That puck stays in the shield zone. Bezhentsev, touch pass, broken up by Malm. A toe drag move was intercepted. St. John can outlet it back down low to Wicklin. Wicklin, sauce pass, D to D. Tom Spreeks has the puck, number 21 in black. He has a goal here tonight for South Muskoka. Bezhentsev can get a pass from Kakarin. That shot was low, and I'm not sure Poulin ever saw that puck. Battling in the corner now. It comes to the blue line where Sorensen's after it. A block by Waugh. McKay back down low. Kakarin guards the blue line, walked the line, played back down for Breeks. Breeks' shot was blocked by St. John, never got on through. It comes to the corner now. Corner boards play. St. John can just aerial lift that one all the way down the length of the ice, and coming out of the cage is Delaney to play dangerously as a bunch of bodies went in flying there. Brandon Mitchell fluttered that puck in his own bench, and so there will be an offensive faceoff coming for the Bradford Rattlers. I beg your pardon. Puck will be dropped just outside of the South Muskoka Shield zone. Sven Musi, clean faceoff win. Daniel Suda just fires it back down low deep. Getting it to it first was Levitsky, but that puck screamed away off of his stick. And now Sven Musi back down low to play it from his own end. turnover. Yalexi then picks it up, and then nearly having his pocket pick was Yalexi. That's a strong stick lift there by Brandon Mitchell. Yalexi is met with a huge hit by Reeves. Levitsky, he meets Doughty in behind the cage. Good pickup by Mulligailov. He'll find down low to Levitsky. Levitsky, Sven Musi, his shot gloved and covered by Delaney. And Sven Musi looks to the heavens. That could have been the hat trick there. Again, clock is still running down here tonight. We are going to be approaching 11 minutes to go right about now. Daniel Burns will turn and fire it, but it's blocked by Kakarin, and oh, that stung. Burns again, his shot blocked in front. Witkowski giving chase back down low. Kakarin can play it off the boards all the way to center, where Palma can re-corral it and give it over to Rodskov, and he can find it ahead to Witkowski's way. Sorensen with Burns on him. Rodin picks up that puck into the corner. He'll sauce a pass low, looking for Witkowski. Couldn't quite stash him there. Sorensen off one leg and make that quick, long stretch pass. Looking for Bozak, but Palma was there to make a good interception there. Ten minutes and 10 seconds to go in this third period. That one is shot back down the length of the ice. On goal to Alexis Poulin, who will elect to cover up that puck with 10 minutes to go exactly in this third period of play. 8 for the Rattlers, 2 for the South Muskoka Shield. The Shens have kept the puck alive in the zone. Hendrik Wicklund couldn't get that puck out of the zone. The shot from the blue line came off the stick of Van Doughty. McKay back to Doughty. Doughty trying to play it back down low, broken up by Lucas Waugh, who has a goal here tonight. He can make a nice stretch pass to Eriksson. Eriksson fanned on the pass, and he lost an edge going down, but still has the puck. Had his pocket picked there by Doughty, but skating it to it first is Kirk Meyer, who tried to wrap it in front and just kind of ran out of real estate there. Where's Kirk Meyer? Lucas Waugh after it. He strips the puck over his man. Eriksson offering some support there. Pashentsev hits his man. That clearing attempt goes as far as the Bradford Rattlers blue line, and so Wicklund can drop it over for St. John. Chip and play made by Eriksson. The Rattlers can get a line change. McKay for the Shield. Drops it back. Sorensen, a shot gloved there by Alexis Poulin. Again, Alexis Poulin, native of Harvey St. Pierre, Quebec, making his first ever junior hockey start here tonight. And if the Poulin family is watching, bonjour to you. Right in front there, and the Shield get it back, and they cash in for their third goal of tonight's contest. South Muskoka, if you're a member of that team, that's exactly what you just kind of want to see. It's slowly but surely, you're making progress. You're down big time to the Bradford Rattlers, 8-2 at the time. You get that third goal, you feel a little better about yourself, trying to get some positives. And that's the one thing South Muskoka has to take into consideration with this third period. Look for positives. Try to win this period. Maybe not win the period, but just start working on your flow better. Start getting some cycle passes going. Start being a little more crisp, maybe even drop a new play even. If you're South Muskoka, you don't really have anything to lose with 7:46 to go in the third period. Shield are back in on the attack. McKay, this is good forechecking by South Muskoka. They're hungry after that third goal and they want a fourth. Levitsky, he's going to have none of that, however, as he can start in. Looking for his fourth goal of the contest, trying to get by Pesentsev. Byrne was there to offer some support, but he couldn't get the puck away. Toms Breeks gains the zone for the Shield. He tried to chip it across the crow's way, and he has it. Number 19 in black can just pitch it on his forehand into the corner. Breaks centering into the slot area. Spear forked away by St. John with one hand. Half corner boards battle. Both teams had two aside down low in that battle, but it comes over to Sorensen. He can thump that puck into the zone. Wicklund after it, number 26 in white for the Bradford Rattlers. He is tied up with Daniel Burns. Two players aside. The puck is still then picked up for the shield right into the slot area, and they score again. It's Brandon Mitchell. Brandon Mitchell gets a fourth spot on the board for the South Muskoka Shield with 6:50 to go in this third period. They are now down by four to cut the lead in half. Stretch feed missed the mark of Kirk Meyer. Richie can then back it back. Where, oh, look out there. Puck bobbled way up in the air off the own skate of Von Doughty. Brandon Mitchell, the latest goal scorer for the Shield, is back in. Tom's Breeks. Breeks had it, lost it. Rodine picks his pocket, plays it off the boards to Kirk Meyer. Kirk Meyer into the zone, fluttering a shot, was low and loose, and it gets kicked aside to the corner where Kirk Meyer can play it down low for Alfred Malm. Pinned up against the boards by Doughty. Malm, he split Rodine and Rozkov at that pass, so you can see Pavel Rozkov hustle down the length of the ice to retrieve that puck from his own end. Breakout pass, he has Amir Mulligailov. Sorensen for the Shield. Played over for McKay. He has a goal here tonight. He'll just flutter it into the corner where Yaleksi will give chase. Very smooth skating defenseman is Braden Yaleksi. Used his wheels there to get that puck into the zone where Lucas Waugh takes it. Took a hit to make the play, but the Rattlers regained possession. Amir Mulligailov, Daniel Suda calling for the puck. He was creeping in front of the high slot area. That allows South Muskoka to take that puck. It's McKay. McKay trying to get by Yaleksi, but Yaleksi very strong. Great defensive awareness there by the Nunavut native. Mulligailov just overskated that puck. That allows the Shield to bring it back down low with Crow dumping it back in. Sven Musi can turn on the Jets here. He gets tripped up, and that will be a penalty on South Muskoka. The netminder Delaney touches up. Bradford Rattlers will be heading to the power play once again. So I'm just reading the comments right now. Number two is Fedor Stuka. Okay, it does have Van Doughty's last name on it. I did have it right, I just started reading the last name that was actually on the name bar of the Shield's name bar on their jerseys. So I do know I have gotten some players wrong today, but that is because the GMHL website has different players and different numbers. And in the actual game, different players are wearing different numbers from what is actually provided to me on the score sheet right here. So if I do get it mixed up, I do apologize. Rattlers on the power play. It's Erickson. Delaney's down and sprawling, trying to locate that puck, but it gets over to Pavel Rozkov. He'll take it back from his own end with 4 minutes to go in this period. 1:10 to go on the power play for Team White. Erickson, number 8. Mulligailov calling for it, but Rozkov takes it. Try to go down on the five hole, and Bukowski kind of got a slash in last moment. Alfred Malm off the faceoff. He'll go wide with Lucas Waugh and Mulligailov heading to the front of the cage. Ryan St. John from the blue line back down low to Malm. Malm looking for Mulligailov. He got him on a touch pass as Suda got it across there. Nice diving effort made by Delaney to make the save, and he kind of bowled over the net while he was at it. The Shield have cut the lead in half. They're down by four, therefore runtime has been stopped. So the clock is now stopped with 3 minutes and 33 seconds to go exactly in this third period. And safe to say, the rest of this contest as well, as it just has been a dominating performance by the top line of the Bradford Rattlers. Steven Levitsky coming in with a hat trick. Sven Musi, he got it all started going on shorthanded. As that 1-0 lead by the South Muskoka Shield seems like it was years ago now. Once Finn Musi got that shorthanded goal, the Bradford Rattlers just never looked back. Put on the gas pedal. The whole 60 minutes, and if you're head coach David Mooney, this is exactly what you want to see. And you don't want to look at the record. One thing that I like to say is when you're looking at a team that you're playing before, like a pre-scouting, you want to play the team, not the record. Mulligailov was looking for that pass, but he was heading off on a change. Pashenza from his own zone can go D-to-D. Stuka can play it across to Pashenza again, and he will corral it across. A stick poe-checking effort made by Tom's Breeks. Brandon Mitchell will just fire it across wide, getting it to it first to Stuka. Stuka will feed it across for Breeks. He centered in front of the net mouth to no avail. Stretch pass looking for Witkowski. Icing is then called on the Bradford Rattlers with 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go in this third period. Defensive zone faceoff for the Rattlers. The Shield win the faceoff. Witkowski doing a good job to pressure off Stuka from the puck. Kirk Meyer took a hit to make a play. Burns takes it back down low. Took a hit as well. Burns, the puck comes right to him. Centering in front of the net. Both battling away as Kirk Meyer, but the puck stays out of the net. Head coach David Mooney will get a line change on for the Bradford Rattlers. Mulligailov, Malm, Waugh, St. John, and Suda are the five out here for the Bradford Rattlers with a minute 52 to go in this third period. That shot by Waugh was kicked aside. Oliver and Malm will skate to it first. He has Mulligailov with him. Kakarin's back defensively. Oliver and Malm going back down low. Couldn't send anything up there. It gets across and the puck comes out of the zone. South Muskoka Shield doing a good job late in this third period just to get some cycle going on, get some passes, and get some, especially some zone time in the Rattlers' end, which the Shield haven't really had much in this contest. But it seems like in the latter goings of this third period, the Shield have been getting more opportunities and more crisp plays that were being executed, I could say. We have 40 seconds to go in this third period. Rattlers with possession, but they give it right back to the Shield. Shield are offside, and so Abraham Palma takes it. Sauce pass then kicked away by Pashentsev, right to Kirk Meyer. Kirk Meyer can get it across Daniel Burns' way. Abraham Palma. Nice play to himself, to Mulligailov. Malagailov shot glove back down and covered. With 15 seconds to go in this third period. Off the faceoff, Wicklund has it. He got a shot away. We have 7 seconds to go. Will the fans take you home? Bradford Rattlers go on to the ice to congratulate their rookie goaltender, Alexis Poula, who wins his first ever junior hockey start. And it's an 8-4 victory over the South Muskoka Shield. Bradford Rattlers now will exit the ice surface after saluting some of the faithful here at the BWG. Bradford Rattlers will be heading off, and so will we. So for Nick Stella and the Bradford Rattlers organization, we bid you all a good hockey night for now.